Hey, watch me in real time make one of these. So, just playing around with some kinky bulk human hair. Natural black, I guess, is the color. But watch me make a lock. I literally just made this, so I'm gonna make another one. These are the tools I'll be using. 0.75 millimeters, three prong. And then a one prong. I actually prefer using this one. This one's kind of, they're both pretty sharp. This one, just three is better than one. That's what she said. Anyway, so. And this one is about, using the sizing tool here. This one. Just kind of just see which lock. This is about half an inch on my sizing tool. Got half, sorry for the smush. So we got 1 inch, half, 5/16, and a quarter. This one is about half an inch, which is a normal size traditional lock. As you can see, flexible, left space out to attach it. I really just grab some hair. This is how the bulk hair comes. See, no format to it. I kind of just grab a little bit. I have this much. I scratch it, which is probably a little backwards because I'm going to stretch it and then fold it over. I like to start in the middle to just give me some base. I take the tool with the hook part facing me or up and just go in and pull the hair. And as I'm pulling, I just turn, pulling hairs out, turning, pulling hairs out on the other side, keep turning. And already you get that little section there. And you just keep going. Once I got that kind of formed, I just go all the way up. I kind of pick a side. I think this is going to be towards the top. So I'm just going to make the bottom of the lock. Yes, it's upside down. There's really no method that I use or rhyme or reason why I go this way. It's just the way that I go. Makes more sense to me and my brain. Obviously, your brain may be a tad bit different. So as I'm going, I turn and turn and turn and turn. I'm really at this moment just trying to form the lock itself. Not really trying to just get a base. It's pretty much, ouch, and I poke myself. You will poke yourself a lot with these, so be careful. I do have the little guards, finger guards and cloth and stuff I can put on it. But this was a spur of the moment thing. I have a client in the morning. I'm nerves guided. I always get nervous and excited when I have a new client coming for an install. So I'm like, when I'm most creative is at night. Should be in a bed. Should be here at 6 a.m. It's gonna be a long day. So pretty much this is the lock, as you can see from the finish lock, and this one that's not finished. Obviously, I still got some little work to do, but I'm gonna leave a little bit at the top. If y'all wondering, I am self-taught, so this is not really something that I do. I mean, obviously I do it in Happy Locks, but this is not something that I was trained to do. I taught myself pretty much, watched a couple videos. Bought the stuff. I'm more of a hands-on person, so once I see it done a few times, I can kind of sort of pick it up. For me, this is something that is easier to do. It's almost, I need to get more of these things. These are kind of bent up from use. use and use, so it's time to get a new one. Just kind of rolling the lock to help things along here. Just testing the strength of it. And that's just, look at this, compared to how easily this was coming. Look, can't even do that with this bulk here, because this is, look, just showing you. If I were to do that with this, and I'm sturdy. Y'all saw here and watched me make it. So, just going in, making sure it's tight. Oops. You leave this part out so you can attach it to the loose hair. If you're making extensions, which pretty much these are, you want to attach it. You may not need as much. You can make these as small as possible, as big as possible. Of course, this again is probably closer to the half inch size of a lock. This one is a little bit more thinner, so I'll probably go back in and rework this a little bit more to make it like this. Let me see. Yeah, just go back in with this tool. This is that first lock I showed you guys. Go back in with that tool to make this a little bit tighter. But other than that, that's how I go from this. Well, from this to these in just a couple minutes. Lock extensions, guys, they're just eyeballing, they're about the same length. This is what they would look like. Give you some startle if you have like hair 3 to 4 inches and just want to look at it length. This will be added to your length that you have. If that, you can even do it with like half, I'm not gonna say having maybe 1 to 2 inches of hair, and you just want to skip that awkward stage to where you can't get styles, this is a good option.